But it does sound really good. I thought this was a good one. It's in the water more than it is on the land. Remember, the other one goes up on the land.
Wow.
That's it. Now you guys
gotta
get off and walk back.
Okay. Cool. Good. Good start.
We do have to go over that safety stuff. So first thing, this sign up here. There's absolutely no smoking on today's tour. We're sitting on about 45 gallons of well-ventilated gasoline. So gas and fire. Not really the best of friends, right?
I like them.
Secondly is those life preservers. They're in these camouflage canopies above. Child life preservers are all the way in the back. That's for if you're 50 pounds and under. 51 pounds above, you would wear the adult ones. So they look like this right here. In the case of an emergency, you just unclip it, unwrap it, open it up, put it around your head, grab the tail, wrap it around your back, clip it right in front. Couldn't get it clipped, a nice bear hug would work the same. But we've actually never had to use these before in our 77 years of operation. So definitely don't plan on starting that one today. Hopefully you guys don't either, right?
Nope.
All right, perfect. Can any of you point out those emergency water exits?
Everywhere.
Yeah, yeah, you guys are smart. Yeah, it's pretty much anywhere, yeah. Up the side, up that side, up front, up back. Pretty much anywhere not green or solid. Wouldn't go too far going up or down there. These green beams on the side, they tend to stick out a bit. So if you do hit your head on one of those, it is safe to say that you have missed your exit. Definitely try again if I were you. Hold yourself, take that deep breath, try that second time. If you do hit your head a second time, you're going to have to chalk that up as natural selection, all right? I'm just kidding.
I hit my head when getting on the boat.
Only got one more try. Yeah.
One.
Tonight's tour, if you guys do not know, it does consist of two parts. So we have on land, on water. While we're on land, I ask that you do stay seated. It gets pretty bumpy. Got those nice Wisconsin roads out there, all the potholes. I really strive to hit all of them. Make it extra fun for us.
Yay!
Yeah, I know. Also keep arms and everything inside the vehicle. Just because we get close to tree branches, I don't want you guys getting scratched or anything. And then when we're on the water, you could stand up, stretch your legs, move around a bit if you wanted to. That's totally up to you. Maybe get a better angle for your picture or something like that. Whatever floats your boat.
Mine would be
all right, perfect. I do just ask you to stay off that back green deck that's all the way back there. It does get a little slippery. Other than that, that is all the safety I have for you.
Nathan loves it.
So we all ready for a duck ride?
Yeah!
All right, that was kind of lame. Are we ready for a duck ride?
Yeah!
All right, let's go.
There we go.
Guys, I don't know if that
camouflage worked on that. Once again, my name is Juliana. We are riding on World War II, and it is stuck.
to the right. To the left. These are our duck barns where we house our 24 fully functional turtle ducks. During the winter, these ducks do like to be inside all the time. But in the summer, the workaholics party hungry sea monarch, just like your duck driver.
Okay.
Please say hey, Steve. Let me know if you guys let me know. Get pretty windy on there, so I advise you all to hold on to any loose items such as hats, sunglasses, and or one of those items. Don't worry, just raise your hand. Try to get my attention. We'll be talking over. old logging company. And unfortunately, it did burn to the ground, so they built this beach as a memorial for that logging company. So that is not what makes it so rare. Does anybody have any guesses why that's so rare there? It's entirely free. Oh. Don't even have to pay for parking there. You guys want to check that out at all?
Thank you.
this one off to the right here. This one that's standing by itself here. This one is called Sugar Bowl Island. Not its name, because I thought it looked like a big overflowing bowl of sugar. You guys see that at all? Maybe not. I personally don't really see that, so I'll tell you what I do see. I am looking at the rear end of an elephant. You guys see that?
Yeah.
Maybe the legs, and that circles his tail there. Yeah. Yep. We call that one Elephant Booty Island. It's more fun to say. Then the next one, the water's kind of taking us fast. So this next one here is just to the right of that house there. This one is called Grotto Rock. It gets its name from all those caves and grotto systems inside. So you can actually take canoes or kayaks through there. A lot of people do that during the summer. Inside there, you can stay about 20 to 30 degrees cooler.
Yes.
Now, since we are riding on a piece of history, I feel like I should give you guys a little history lesson. So these ducks were made between the years of 1942 and 1945. There was about 21,000 or so of them made. Of the 21,000, about 11,000 sought action. Anybody want to take a guess at how many made it back home of that 11,000? 200? That's a pretty good guess. Any others? 30? Those are good guesses. It's actually just one duck. Just one duck made it back home. So it's sitting in a museum in Boston now. And what happened to the other 11,000? U.S. found it was just much quicker, cheaper, and easier to manufacture all of the ducks here. So they stripped them of all their valuable parts and then sunk them in the oceans.
Alright.
And those other 10,000 that weren't used in action, those are the ones that were then sold to private investors.
So Biden was in the government then?
So there's only about 300 left in the whole world, and about half of those are right here in the Downs. And then this next rock formation, right in front of us here, this is called the Twin Inkstands. Not its name, thought it looked like a couple of inkstands or inkwells that you have sitting on your desk. So you can see that the two blacks might be those inkstands. The black would be that ink overflowing down the sides. And the trees on top would be those feather quills that you need to strike with. Look out the rear end of a duck. These bragging rights are all yours now. So this does conclude the water portion of today's tour. We're going to be making our way back to the private property. However, while these homeowners are out here, have kindly asked us to shut our microphones off. So I'll respect that. Once we do get back to property, we'll have a little Q&A session where I'd love to answer any of the questions you might have collected along the way.
Why is it short?
Why is it short?
Yeah.
trying to escape. You actually do purchase these ducks just how you see them, strip them of their valuable parts, and then put them into our tour ducks, trying to keep them as original as possible.
Thank you.